Now to Easley, where the cleanup continues following the tornado that ripped through the downtown area. Homeowners and businesses are trying to get things back to normal and trying to figure out how much money it's going to cost to do that. News 4's Keisha Foster joins us live from Easley with more, and a train is coming. Keisha, cleanup isn't the only focus.
No, it isn't, Nigel. Business and homeowners spent another day talking with their insurance agents about the damage that the tornadoes caused, and just simply trying to figure out how to move forward.
Never saw anything like this in my life.
This is the scene at Easley RV Center on Ross Avenue.
Well, we got four totaled for sure, and we got about six others with damage. It'll probably be somewhere in the $50,000, $60,000 loss. Just on the trailers itself.
Owner James Whitmire is busy, like many others, trying to bounce back after the storm.
Hey, we were closed yesterday, and we came down and done a lot of assessment on what damage we had. And today we've been dealing with appraisers, adjusters, and all, trying to figure out what's going on with it.
Various pockets of the Easley community were impacted by the tornado.
I would say probably about $30,000, $40,000 worth of damage on awning-wise.
This team with Upstate Awning has been working steadily all morning along Main Street.
Yeah, mixed blessing. Yeah, we glad to have the work. So we just gonna keep on rolling down through here and taking them down and getting them to get ready to put new ones back up.
Right now, everyone is trying to tally up the damage. A recovery manager with the State Emergency Management Division is in town to help figure out what type of assistance may be available to those trying to recover.
There are different types of federal assistance. There's public assistance, individual assistance, and then the Small Business Administration. Each one of those programs have separate thresholds that need to be met. Currently, we don't know what all the damages are. The tax assessors locally are making those assessments, and once we do have that information, then we'll know how to proceed.
Now, Main Street is once again open, especially in the area that was blocked off between Pendleton and South First Streets. And it also means that the 7 o'clock curfew has been lifted. On a lighter note, the Christmas tree lighting ceremony will go on as scheduled, and that will take place at 6:30 tomorrow. And the Christmas parade scheduled for Saturday will also take place at 10 o'clock as scheduled. Keisha Foster, WYFF News 4, live in downtown Easley.